It's the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Monday, the 19th of November. I'm Michael Graff. It's Thanksgiving week. The weather looks to cooperate for the most part, with a gradual downtrend in temperatures through the end of the week. Could we see just a little bit of rain in parts of the state for Thanksgiving Day? Well, we'll talk about that and everything else. Let's get out there and look at the almanac from yesterday. 74 for the high, 51 the morning low, and that is just about perfect, where we should be, at least in terms of our normals. And outside right now, here at 5:55 a.m., clear skies in the valley. Currently 48 degrees at Sky Harbor, dew points at 32, humidity 53%. The winds are light and the barometer is rising. Temperatures out there this morning, 36 at Fort McDowell and Goldfield. Most of us are in the 40s and 50s at this hour. Pretty seasonal temperatures. Around the nation, temperatures look rather seasonal as well, with the exception of the far northern plains. We've got some single digits and teens, but that's not unheard of for mid to late November, and some cold air in parts of the northeast also. The real cold stuff way up there in Canada, and that will be headed southward in coming days, so watch for that. The upper air look across the country, most of the nation is under the influence of a broad trough, and a fairly progressive pattern here for the southern tier of the United States, which we'll get into in a moment. The watch warning map is rather quiet for this time of year. Dense fog advisories in portions of the southeast. Winter weather advisories across New England. Some air quality alerts in California. Those don't show up on this map, but they are there thanks to the wildfires. And we'll continue to see some smoke drift across Arizona from time to time as well. Convective outlook for today, no organized areas of severe weather anywhere across the contiguous United States, although a little thunder possible along the Gulf Coast. And rainfall for the next 7 days, well, really nothing here in the valley, maybe some light precip across northern Arizona. We'll get into the details of all of it now. Let's check out the models. This is the GFS, the 06Z run, valid at 5 o'clock this afternoon. Upper low to the west, high pressure in control for now. So down at the surface, today looks mostly sunny this morning, partly sunny this afternoon. Highs this afternoon mostly in the mid-70s. Tonight, partly cloudy, lows mid-40s to mid-50s. Tomorrow, we've got that low approaching from the west. It starts to weaken, becomes more of an open wave type feature. A little bit of warm air advection out ahead of it, too. So despite the fact that we'll have a mostly cloudy sky, I think we might actually be warmer tomorrow than today. Highs mid, maybe even upper 70s. And could there be a shower someplace, I guess, but there's just not enough forcing or moisture with this system to really be concerned about that, so we're going to keep it out of the forecast. All right, here's Wednesday, the busiest travel day of the year. Pick out your destination. Weather shouldn't be too much of a problem across the country. A little bit of rain and mountain snow along the west coast with a cold front. We've got some light rain and snow in sections of the northeast and along the Texas Gulf Coast, a little bit of light rain as well. Temperatures a little below average in the northern tier states, especially toward New England and the northern Great Lakes, but generally a nice day, and that's true for around here too, with mostly sunny skies. We should be, I'd say, in the mid-70s. All right, Thanksgiving Day, we've got a cold front coming in from the west. There's just a little bit of forcing and very limited moisture with this. A slight chance of showers. The GFS actually shows a completely dry day for us, but the European has some light rain coming on through. It's a little bit deeper, a little bit more bullish with the precipitation chances. So we'll put in a small chance of showers for Thanksgiving. A bit cooler too, with highs somewhere right around 70. Cool air comes in for Friday behind our front. So highs mid and upper 60s, just a little bit below average. And then over the weekend, shortwave energy helps to keep the cool air around. So Saturday and Sunday, highs mostly upper 60s to near 70. With periods of clouds from time to time, but conditions should overall stay dry. Kicking off next week, this is Monday the 26th. We've got a short wave passing through the Four Corners, but that still looks dry. Highs in the upper 60s to near 70. Tuesday the 27th, a high latitude blocking pattern sets up. The southern branch of the jet remains somewhat progressive, though, and high temperatures will remain maybe just ever so slightly below average, right around the upper 60s to near 70. And then this is the end of the 10-day forecast period. Wednesday, the 28th, got another wave approaching from the west. This one will undercut our ridge, it looks like, and that's kind of the pattern that we look to see finishing out November and into early December, sort of an undercutting progressive pattern with these troughs coming on through and maybe just a better chance of rain overall if that pans out. All right, let's check out the numbers through the period coming off the GFS Ensemble. Highs, well, it's got us all the way up to 78 tomorrow. We could be there. And then more or less temperatures not far from average to round out November and head on into December. 70s, maybe upper 60s, lows in the 40s. Looks good. That's going to do it for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video back here tomorrow morning. If you like our videos, be sure to subscribe so that whenever we post a brand new one, you'll get the notifications. And your comments, questions, and suggestions always encouraged as well. I always love to hear your feedback. And so you guys be safe out there. Have yourselves a fantastic Monday. And of course, here's your forecast.